morning, everyone, and a very happy Easter. Let us prepare ourselves to celebrate in song.
Lord have mercy. Thank you. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, your life, appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We now invite you to join in the Easter sequence. Christians, to the Paschal victim, offer your thankful praises. A lamb the sheep redeems. Christ, who only is sinless, reconciles sinners to the Father. Death and life have contended in that combat stupendous. The Prince of Life, who died, reigns immortal. Speak, Mary, declaring what you saw, wayfaring. The tomb of Christ, who is living, the glory of Jesus' resurrection. Bright angels attesting, the shroud and napkin resting. Yes, Christ, my hope, is arisen. To Galilee, he goes before you. Christ, indeed, from death is risen. Our new life obtained. Have mercy, Victor King, ever reigning. Amen. Alleluia.
Not the burial cloth, but rolled up in a separate place.
Then the other disciple also went in, the one who arrived at the tomb first. And he saw and believed. For they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We can never tire of saying the words, Jesus Christ is risen. Even from a distance, still with each other, and thank you for joining us for Mass. Put yourself in Mary Magdalene's place for a moment. The one you have come to love and understand to be the Messiah has been crucified. You watched him die, and you saw the place where he was entombed. And on early Sunday morning, she goes to the tomb. So much has changed for her. Things she thought about Jesus perhaps have changed for her. What other people have said about Jesus have changed. And as she nears the tomb, where the one she's come to love has been buried, she sees the stone is rolled away. She doesn't go into the tomb. It's still dark, it's early morning. But she makes her way back to Simon Peter and the other disciple. And she says, they've stolen Jesus. I don't know where they put him. I don't know where they've taken him. That announcement certainly unsettles Peter and the other disciples. So they leave and they go also on their way to the tomb. And the disciple, presumably younger, outruns Peter. And he too gets to the tomb and bends down and he looks. Doesn't go into the tomb just yet. But he sees the burial cloths. And then, of course, Peter gets there, goes in, and he too sees the burial cloths. And then the younger disciple goes in, he sees, and the scripture says, he believes. There's something important about those burial cloths. You'll recall when Jesus raises Lazarus from the dead. He calls Lazarus out of the tomb and he comes out in his burial cloths. And Jesus says, untie him and let him go. Lazarus would have to die again. Jesus, who will not die again, leaves even the burial cloths in the tomb with death itself. If they had stolen the body of Jesus, they would not likely have left the burial cloths. But Jesus leaves them behind in the tomb just as he has left death behind and has been risen, is raised up. Important little detail. On this Easter morning, my brother and my sisters, we, like Mary, have come to find Jesus. But we ask ourselves, truly, what are we looking for? What do we hope to see? Whom do we hope to encounter? How will we know that Jesus is risen from the dead? Do we come to the tomb in haste, running, like Peter and the other disciple? You and I not there. He is risen. He has been raised up. And then we leave the tomb and we say, and I believe. Even though I can't perhaps fully understand and comprehend resurrection, I believe. I believe that Jesus has been raised from the dead. And I believe that he lives, and I believe that because of him, I too live. Like Peter, in the first reading, you and I are commissioned to go forth in the name of Jesus to preach, to proclaim, and to testify on Jesus' behalf, he is risen. To testify, to proclaim, to preach, Jesus is risen. And that everyone who believes in him will have forgiveness of their sins. We acknowledge, and that's why we gather today. We acknowledge that Jesus is risen. That part of his ministry is complete. Jesus has done his part as he promised. Today, the work of Easter comes back to us, those who have been commissioned to preach and to testify. So to whom will we go to this very day? Who will we call? Who will we text? Who will we somehow or other communicate with the message of Easter? That Jesus is risen from the dead. And it causes us to say, Alleluia, Alleluia. It causes us to live our lives differently today than we did yesterday. What will our message be today, my brothers and sisters? If it's not about the resurrection. Jesus left death behind. Can we? With renewed faith, let us join one another as we profess the Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead Lord, hear our prayer.
For elected leaders, may God's wisdom guide them in their work to protect the dignity and sanctity of human life from conception through natural death. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those afflicted with pain or sorrow, may Jesus, the divine physician, console and comfort them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who gather today, may the Holy Spirit continue to increase in us the virtues of faith, hope, and love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ, may they be embraced by the risen Lord this day. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those who have been impacted by the coronavirus pandemic, and for all the emergency workers and first healthcare responders who are attending to their needs, may the Lord grant them strength, protection, and comfort. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And for each of our particular needs, prayers, and concerns which we hold deep within our hearts. On this Easter day, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. O good and gracious God, who will never be outdone in generosity, who have given us Jesus, your Son, to be our Savior, we entrust these our prayers to you in his name, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Exalted with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many. memory of me.
For the kingdom, the power.
power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the risen Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Thank you.
We now invite you to join in an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray.
Blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down.